मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 7 फ्रैक्शन एक्सरसाइज 7.6 क्वेश्चन नंबर 2। क्वेश्चन 2 हैव सरिता बाट 2x5 मीटर ऑफ रिबन, सरिता बाट 2x5 मीटर ऑफ रिबन एंड ललिता बाट 3x4 मीटर ऑफ रिबन। What is the total length of ribbon they bought? Okay, so here given Sarita bought 2x5 meter of a ribbon and Lalita 3x4 meter of a ribbons. What is the total length of ribbon they bought? So here V plus 2x5 and 3x4, then we obtain total length of ribbons. Okay, so let's start how to do it. So first we write ribbon bought by Sarita. Sarita bought ribbon, so ribbon bought by Sarita, clear? So here we write ribbon bought by Sarita. This is given, Sarita bought 2x5 meters. Okay, so 2x5 per meter we take m. Okay, in this question the given is given that ribbon bought by Sarita is 2x5 meters and ribbon bought by Lalita, okay, ribbon bought by Lalita ribbon bought by Lalita is equal to 3x4 meters. This is given 3x4 meters. Okay, so what is the total length of ribbon? Okay, question ask what is the total length of the ribbon they bought. So we find here total length of ribbon. So for this we plus it 2x5 and 3x4. Okay, so here we can write total length of ribbon. Total length of ribbon is equal to total length of ribbons. For this you find the sum of ribbon bought by Sarita and the sum of ribbon bought by Lalita. So ribbon bought by Sarita is 2x5 and ribbon bought by Lalita is, this is given 3x4. Okay, you can see here this is fraction form 2x5 and 3x4, both have different denominators, here 5 and here 4. So you can see 5 is a prime number, so LCM of this is 4 into 5, this is equal to 20. If you find the LCM, LCM is equal to 20, 4 into 5, because here you can see here 5 is the prime number. So in this case, if one denominator is prime number, then we direct multiply by the other denominators and we find the LCM. Okay, so also you can solve this, because this is the prime numbers and they are unlike fraction. So first you multiply 2 into 4, so 2 into 4, after this plus 5 into 3 divide by 4 into 5. You can also solve this is equal to 5 into 4 is 20 here. This is your LCM, 20. Okay. After this, if you divide this 5 to this 5, this LCM 20, you have to 4. So here 2 into 4. Plus, if you divide 5 into 4 by 4, then you have to 5. So you can see 5 multiplied by 3. So in this way, you can write here 8 plus 15 by 20. Okay. 8 plus 15 by 20, you can see 2 4 ja 8 plus 5 3 ja 15. So again state 8 plus 15 is equal to 23. 8 plus 15 is equal to 23 by 20. 23 by 20, you can see here. This is the total length of ribbon bought by Sarita and Lalita. Okay? Clear? So you can also write like this. If you convert it in mixed fraction, so as you can see, this is improper fraction because this is 23 by 20. 23 is greater than 20. It means that numerator is greater than denominator. Here numerator is 23 and denominator is 20. When the numerator is greater than the denominator, this is the form of improper fractions. So we can change it in proper fractions. Okay. If you divide 23 by 20, then you obtain quotient 1 and remainder 3. Look like this. This is 23. This is numerator. And this is the denominator 20. If you divide it by 20, then you obtain 21 ja 20. Okay. After this, you can subtract. You know how to divide. And here, 3 minus 0 is 3. And this is okay. So you can write this is the remainder. This is quotient. This is a denominator. So form of fraction is this is a quotient. Quotient minus and divided remainder by denominator. Okay, and you can see also this is divisor. So you can write here 1 is quotient, 3 remainders, and 20 you can say denominators are divisor. So if you change 23 by 20. This is improper fraction into mixed fraction. This is improper fraction into mixed fraction. Then we obtain 1 whole 3 by 20. Mixed fraction is the part. Is the mixed fraction have two part. First part is whole number. Second part is proper fraction. So you can see here. This is first part. This is whole numbers. And 3 by 20. This is a proper fraction. So mixed fraction made by two parts. First part is whole number, other part is proper fractions. Okay. So student, I hope all of you understood. In this question, this is given that the Sarita bought 2 by 5 meters of ribbons and Lalita bought 3 by 4 meters of ribbon. Question asked to us, what is the total length of ribbon? So total length of ribbons, we sum the ribbon bought by Sarita and the ribbon bought by Lalita. So here you can see ribbon bought by Sarita is given 2 by 5 and the ribbon bought by Lalita is 3 by 4. This is given and we need to find that total length of ribbon is equal to 2 by 5 plus 3 by 4. Okay. So here you can see if you observe the denominator of both fractions, they are different. It means that they are unlike terms. And here, this denominator is 5. 5 is prime number. So you can solve easily to find LCM 20, or you can use another method, cross multiplication method like this. If you multiply this numerator by this denominator, 2 into 4, okay, plus 5, this denominator into this numerator, 5 into 3. Okay, after this multiply by both denominator 5 into 4. This is equal to 20 also, this is LCM. So for 2 4 ja 8 and 5 3 ja 15 plus. Okay, so 8 plus 15 is 23 by 20. This is a required answer. The total length of ribbon bought by Sarita and Lalita. But if you want to change it in a mixed fraction, because this is in proper fraction, then you divide this numerator 23 by 20, then you have to quotient is 1 and the remainder is 3. So in this way you can convert the given in proper fractions. 23 by 20, this is equal to 1 whole 3 by 20. So student, I hope all of you understood this question. Question number 2. Now we are going to discuss question number 3. What is the question number 3? Let's see. Naina was given, question number 3 hai. Naina was given 1.5 piece of cake and Najma was given 1 by 3 piece of cake. Find the total amount of cake was given to both of them. Okay, so here in this question, Naina was given 1 by 2 piece of cake and Najma was given 1 by 3 piece of cake. Find the total amount. We need to find here the total amount of cake was given both of them. So let's see how to solve it. In case also you plus the total cake taken. Okay, so here Naina is given 1 by 2 piece of cake and Najma is given 1 by 3 piece of cake. So if you plus them, then we obtain the total amount of cake. Okay, so let's see. This is question number 3. Okay, so first we write here cake taken by Naina. Okay, and cake taken by Naina. Okay, so what amount of cake taken by given by Naina is 1 whole 1 by 2. Okay, cake taken by Naina or cake given by Naina is 1 whole 1 by 2 piece of cake and cake taken by Najma. Okay, now cake taken by Najma is equal to cake taken by Najma is equal to 1 whole 1 by 3. Okay, here this is a mixed fractions, you can change it in improper fractions. So 2 1 2 plus 1, this is equal to 2 1 2 plus 1, this is equal to 3 by 2. And here you can also change 3 1 jar 3 plus 1, 4 by 3. Okay, how can you convert the mixed fraction into the improper fraction? You know very well, but look here, that is given 1 whole 1 by 2. This is a mixed fraction. If you convert it in improper fractions, so you can first multiply 2 into this. This whole part is multiplied by denominator 1 into 2. After this, numerator is added. Okay, divide by denominators. Okay, so you can see here 2 इंटू वन इंटू टू इज इक्वल टू टू प्लस वन बाई टू. आफ्टर दिस यू नो रिजल्ट, टू प्लस वन इज थ्री, दिस इज इक्वल टू थ्री बाई टू. ओके अगेन यू कैन वॉट वन वन होल वन बाई थ्री, सो दिस इज अ मिक्स फ्रैक्शन वन होल वन. वेन यू कन्वर्ट मिक्स फ्रैक्शन ओके इन टू इम प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन इन इच केस द न्यूमरेटर इज ग्रेटर देन डिनोमिनेटर्स. ओके सी हियर यू कैन सी न्यूमरेटर इज थ्री, हियर यू कैन सी न्यूमरेटर इज थ्री एंड डिनोमिनेटर इज टू. सो यू कैन सी न्यूमरेटर इज ग्रेटर देन डिनोमिनेटर्स, आर यू कैन से हियर थ्री इज ग्रेटर देन टू. ओके सो दिस इज इम प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शंस. नाउ and in this case this is a mixed fractions, here this is a whole part is 1, remainder is 1 and the denominator is 3. So for this, if you want to convert this in improper fraction, so first you multiply whole part by denominator, so 1 into 3, and after this we add the result by numerator, so here numerator is 1 and divide by this denominator 3. So 1 into 3, this is equal to 3. 3 plus 1 by 3. 1 into 3, this is equal to 3. And 3 plus 1, after this plus 1, this is the numerators. And 3 plus 1 is 4. This is equal to 4 by 3. Okay. So you can also see here 4 by 3 is an improper fraction because the numerator is 4 and denominator is 3. 4 is greater than 3, so you can say this is an improper fractions. Now come to the point, we need to find total cake taken. Okay, total cake taken. So let total so cake taken by 9, Naina is 3 by 2, or you can say 1 whole 1 by 2, and cake taken by Najma is 1 whole 1 by 3, or you can say 4 by 3. Okay, so we need to sum them. So here this is a 1 plus 1, sorry, 1 whole 1 by 2 plus 1 whole 1 by 3. Here you convert it in improper fraction. 3 by 2 plus 4 by 3. Okay, so what is the LCM of 2? Here you can see both are improper fraction, and this is a unlike fractions, and the denominator of both fractions is 2 and 3, both are prime numbers. So for this you can multiply 3 into this 3, because both are prime numbers. For this, if both are prime numbers, so you can find the LCM direct. LCM of 2 and 3 is 6. You can say LCM of 2 and 3, this is equal to 6. Okay, LCM of 2 and 3, this is equal to 6. Clear? Now LCM of 2 and 3 is equal to 6, so you can write here 6. Okay, and if you divide 6 by 2, then you obtain 3. So this 3 into this 3. Okay, now plus, clear? And if you divide this 6 by this 3, then you obtain 2. If you divide 6 by 3, you obtain quotient is 2. So we multiply this quotient to this numerator, 4 into 2. Okay, 4 into 2, this is equal to 3, 3 is 9. 3, 3 is 9 into 4, 2 is 8 by 6. You can also write this is equal to, this is not multiplication, this is addition. 9 into 9 plus 8. 9 plus 8 is 17. Okay, 9 plus 8 is 17 by 6. Clear? 17 by 6. If you, this is an improper fraction. The total part, the total cake is given, okay, at taken is 17 by 6. The question asks us find the total number of, find the total amount of cake was given to both of them. So here total amount of cake is 17 by 6. This is improper fractions. You can change it in mixed fraction. So for this we divide numerator by denominators. Okay, numerator is 17 and denominator is here 6. If you divide 17 by 6, you obtain question 2. 6 2 is 12. And what is the remainder? Remainder is 5. 7 minus 2 is 5 here. Okay, this is the numerator, sorry, denominator. This is the numerator, this is a question, this is a remainder. So this is equal to, we can write here, this is equal to 2 whole 5 by 6. Okay, the total consumption of cake, okay, is 2 whole 5 by 6. So student, I hope all of you understood these questions. Okay, in these questions, this is given that Nana was given one whole 1 by 2 piece of cake. Najma was given one whole 1 by 3 piece of cake. So question asks us find the total amount of cake was given to both of them. So here you can see, first you write the cake taken by Naina or given by Naina. Okay, 1 whole 1 by 2, this is equal to 3 by 2. And cake taken by Najma, 1 whole 1 by 3, this is equal to 4 by 3. After this, total cake taken, okay, or you can write here the total consumption of cake. Okay, so 1 whole 1 by 2 plus 1 whole 1 by 3, this is equal to 3 by 2 plus 4 by 2. Okay, so you can see here the denominators of both fractions is prime numbers. So directly you can find the LCM, 2 into 3. Okay, you can also write this is 2 into 3, this is equal to 6. Okay, because both denominator of both fraction are prime numbers. Okay, so here this is 6. If you divide 6 by 2, then after you 3. So this 3 into this quotient, 3 into 3, plus if you divide 6 by this 3, we after into, so 4 into 2. So 3 into 3 is equal to 9, plus 4 into 2 is equal to 8. So 9 plus 8 is equal to 17. 17 by 6. If you want to change it this is improper fraction, because you can see here the 17 is greater than 6, it means that numerator is greater than denominator. Okay, so this is improper fraction. If you want to change it in mixed fraction, so you divide numerator by denominator. Okay, so here you can say 6, 17 divided by 6, so you obtain quotient 2 and remainder of 5. So you can write 2 over 17 by 6 is equal to 2 over 5 by 6. This is a total amount of cake, okay, given to the both of them, or you can say total consumption of cake. Okay, total consumption of cake is 2 over 5 by 6. Okay, now, so student, I hope all have understood these questions, and now we are going to discuss question number 4. This is the fill in the blanks. Okay, fill in the boxes is given here. So let's see how to fill the given boxes. Okay, So question number 4 is given here. Okay, fill in the boxes. Okay, A part of question number 4 is that boxes. This is given boxes minus 5 by 8 is equal to 1 by 4. Okay. Boxes minus 1 by boxes minus 5 by 8. Okay. Is equal to 1 by 4. So we put some fractions in boxes that we subtract 5 by 3 5 by 8, then we obtain 1 by 4. So you can see here very carefully, this is minus 5 by 8, then we obtain 1 by 4. So for this we find the value of box is here minus and this is a plus, so we can plus them. We get, if we add them 1 by 4 plus 5 by 8, then we find the value of box. Okay, then we find the what fractions we write in this given box. Okay, so this is minus, so we add them. Okay, so 1 by 4 plus 5 by 8. So let's see here what is the LCM. You can see the both fractions. Okay, the fraction of this denominator. Diameter of this fraction is 4 and the diameter of this fraction is 8. Okay, so 8 is the multiple of 4, 4 to 8, 8 is the multiple of 4, so LCM is equal to 8 here. Okay, if you divide this 8 by 4, so 4 to 8, so we have 2 and 2 1 ja 2. Clear? Again, plus here, and if you divide this 8 by this 8, so 8 1 ja 8, we have quotient 1. So 5 into 1 is equal to 5. So here you can see that we obtain 2 plus 5. 2 plus 5 is 7. So this obtain 7 by 8. Okay. So we can fill here 7 by 8. Okay. So you can see easy way. This is a 7 by 8. This is 7 by 8. If you subtract 7 by 8, 7 by 8 minus 5 by 8, if you subtract 5 by 8 from 7 by 8, then you have done, you can verify it, 7 by 8 minus 5 by 8. Okay, so here you can see denominator of both fractions are same, so this is like term, so you can write it 8, 7 minus 5. This is equal to 7 minus 5 is 2, so 2 by 8. Okay. So you can also write 2 1 ja 2, 2 4 ja 8, 2 1 ja 2, 2 4 ja 8. So you can see 1 by 4 and 1 by 4. Okay. So in this fractions, in these boxes we write 7 by 8. Okay. If you subtract 5 by 8 from 7 by 8, you find 1 by 4. Okay. Let's see next part, B part of this question number 4. B part is given. This is given box. Okay. Again minus 1 by 5. 1 by 5. This is equal to 1 by 2. Okay. We need to find which fractions we write in this box that we subtract 1 by 5. Then we obtain 1 by 2. Okay, so for this, here you can see this is minus and this is plus. So for the value of boxes, we plus this and this. 1 by 2, we plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 5. Because here you can see this is minus. Okay, so LCM of 2 and 5, because both 2 and 5 are prime number, so LCM of 2 and 5 is 10. So 5 2 ja 10, 5 times 5 1 ja 5. Okay, plus if you divide 10 by 5, you have 2. 5 2 ja 10, 2 times, and 2 5 ja 10. So 5 2 ja 10, so here we have 2 into 1, this is equal to 2. And 5 plus 2 is equal to 7, 7 by 10. So you can write here as 7 by 10. Okay? This is clear. In this way, we write in box. Is 7 by 10. If you subtract 1 by 5 from 7 by 10, then we obtain 1 by 2. So student, I hope all of you understood how to fill in boxes. So thank you for watching. Jai Hind.